Let me just have the backups.
Uweponi mwako nikae Bwana. Uweponi mwako nikae Bwana milele nikae uweponi mwako milele nikae uweponi mwa uweponi mwako
Somebody lift up your voice.
Wepo
ni mwako
milele.
Milele.
Oh.
Wepo ni mwako.
Wepo ni mwako. Nikae Bwana. Wepo ni mwako. Nikae Bwana milele nikae uweponi mwako milele nikae uweponi
mwako nikae
Bwana
uweponi
wewe Bwana kimbilio jingine ila wewe Bwana nikae weponi mwako milele nikae weponi
somebody
weponi mwako
weponi
lift up your voice.
Oh, weponi,
weponi mwako.
Oh,
milele,
milele. Oh,
weponi,
somebody,
milele.
Let me listen to your voice. Somebody lift up your voice. My desire is to walk in the presence, is to serve in your presence, is to walk in your presence, is to swim in your presence. In the name of Jesus, my God, in the name of Jesus, how we adore you, we lift your name. Rabagatagataya, Zelebadozaya. Somebody, you can lift up your voice and you can speak to him. Somebody, you can do more than that. Lada baganda, selebayanda, lapakandoza, seleba, zeketeanda. Father, we lift your name. We give you glory, but we desire to walk in your presence. We give you praise. We adore you. We love you. And for in Jesus Christ we pray. Somebody can put your hands together. More than that, more than that, more than that. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. God bless you. Put your hands together to the praise and worship. You guys are amazing. Wow. So don't sit behind. Take the front seat. Somebody can take the front seat. Amen. 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 No far end. Come this side. No far end. No far end. Right. Praise the living God. So it's like today I'm going to focus this side. And I'm going to focus this side spiritually. Say amen. So you will play me the strings. If you are there, you can give your neighbor a high five. A high five. You know, a high five is not this five. This is a low five. A high five is a high five. Give your neighbor a high five. Amen. Heavens, come and sit here. Come and sit here. Leo nimekupea kiti ya jadolo. Amen. Amen. Tell your neighbor you look amazing. Tell your neighbor you look amazing. Praise the name of the Lord. I've come to understand something that is very critical. And allow me, God use me today to speak to you. Praise the living God. Amen. Allow me this day for God to use me to speak to you. For I want to speak. Praise the name of the Lord. Listen. Anytime I found myself in the presence of the Lord, I don't take the message that comes that it belongs to somebody else. It belongs to me. Praise the living God. So allow me today to speak to you. Not any other person. To you. Somebody say, God speak to me. God speak to me. So tonight, without wasting my time, I've come to understand where power lives. Listen, the Bible says in John chapter number 1 and verse number 1 that in the beginning there was wow. Somebody let us go together. In the beginning was the word. And the word was with God. And the word was, listen to this. Praise the living God. My topic today is that you only need God. Nothing else. Praise the living God. Mirel Bwana Sifiwe. Are you Mirel from Ngea Girls? So I know you. Amen. You only need God. Nothing else. So it is God and it is period. And that's what the Bible says. In the beginning was the word. So come to Genesis chapter number 1 and verse number 1. The Bible says that in the beginning God created heaven and Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. Stop jewelowing the surface of your face, Vincent. Smile to me. Say amen. Somebody give me amen. Let me tell you. When a preacher preaches and you keep quiet, it means you are in your world. You are in your own world. So allow us to do this together. And let us preach just together and God will bless us, right? Somebody give me amen. Somebody give me amen. Yeah. Give me amen. And that's why one day I went to a certain meeting and people were not saying amen. Do you know what I did? I told them to stand up, everybody. Let me tell you. Amen inapigika kama umesimama. Wanaweza sifiwe. Hapo ukika, naanza kusinzia. Wengine pia wanachafua hewa. Say amen. Amen. So you only need God. The Bible says something else. In the beginning, it was God that created heaven and earth. In the beginning. So come back to what I want to teach us today, so that we may share and get something. We go home. Today, many of us are looking for a diverse things. You find us walk in this world today, but the things we desire are a lot of things. Listen to this. Today, you find many of us goes to school to get knowledge. And after getting knowledge, all right. Many of us go to school, and that is very true, so that their tomorrow not to remain the same. Sio ni ukweli? Listen. Today, all of us desire to remain people that are representable. People that when you appear before men, you are so representable. He's the living God. And today, people have taken their being representable to become number one. More than things that are very important. Listen to this. I love what Apostle said one day when he was in a certain prayer rally. But today, churches have become a fashion show. Please. Hallelujah. Yenye mutu wakivaa nguo week one. Na? In a month. Anaivaa tena after 5 months. Hama vai. Every Sunday is a day of fashion show. Praise the living God. Until many of our believers have forgotten the core business of church and they are focusing in their own things. There's a living God. Listen to this. Today, if you want to know a lady, yeah, a lady, listen to this. The only time that a lady can be too busy, more than anything, kama nataka kuenda kusonga na kuna date. Say amen. Eti musichana akae na nywele 1 month ajasonga. Huh? Hey. Anakufa. Listen. A lady cannot sustain having one hairstyle for a month. Praise the living God. Listen, we can look at, listen to this. Somebody can spend 2,000 kwa kichwa, kutengeneza kichwa, nywele. Yeah? Wanaweza sifiwe. Na ni 2,000 yenye ametengeneza after a month anaingoa. Ha? Alafu kwa chat, kutoa tu sadaka, ni shida. Let me talk to you now. Kutoa sadaka ni shida. Anaweza spend. Listen, the Bible says, whatever you plant is whatever you do what? You sow. You reap. So listen. Today, there are nasty things that we have invested our time on. More than investing time in serving God. Listen to this. There is no time wasted when somebody invested his time in serving God. No time wasted. So listen to this. It is only today that a man will spend money on a lady more than spending money in church. Because of what? Listen. There is no love that is bought by money. Somebody give me amen. Yes, give me a good amen. There is no love that is being bought by money. And listen, money is a currency. To me, whenever somebody gives out something, he expects a return. Ushaienda kwa duka ukambia mtu wa duka chukua pesa nimekupea. Aki chukua. Ha? Hata wewe wale watu wanasemanga keep change ni watu wa deni. Jua leo acha nimwachia keep change. Kesho nitarudi si unisaidie hapo sukari kilo nitakuletea. Ili mtu ugain trust. Upake sayenya. Give me amen. Praise the living God. There is nothing. Listen. Money is a currency. It is a modern of exchange. So when you receive something, you expect a sink. Praise the living God. They are what? Sink. They can be hospitalized. Hey, praise the living God. I'll lift your hand and say amen. Listen to this. Give me the Bible in the book of Matthew chapter number 16 and verse number 26. Listen to me. Today, we are in a dispensation of time where people don't care about God. Today is the day where people respect men of God more than God. Praise the living God. The Bible says, for what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world? Listen. Many of us today want to be known. They want to be identified. They want to be recognized. Listen to me. They want fame. They want to live a life that has no meaning even to the society. The Bible says, that for what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world? So listen to me. So today, what profit do you gain if you own the whole world? So let me roll it down to my revelation, the way God is giving me and opening my mind. If you look at the world, listen to this. There are people who desire to live a better life and to have money. Do you understand that there are people that money has killed? Let me tell you. Right now, Evans, who pay 1 billion, you will die. There's a living God. You will die. In fact, you will even walk out of salvation. And that's why the reason why God knows what we need, not what we want. And the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter number 1 and verse number 9, that our God is too faithful to them that fellowship together with his son. So he's too faithful to do whatever you ask him to do. As a living God, still faithful. God is faithful by whom you are called into the fellowship with his son, Jesus Christ our Lord. So he is a faithful God. Have you ever seen people who are praying for fake husbands? And they're even going for prayer and fasting. Watimo na winie. Kata wui mi lamone no fake. Say amen. Give me amen. Listen to this. God gives you whatever you want. And the Bible says, but he is not a man to lie. If he says he is faithful, he will surely do, because he is faithful. Listen to this. Do you think God had no power to stop Delilah from getting into Samson? Think God had no power? He had power to stop Delilah from getting into the life of Samson. But what is it that made Samson to got into Delilah? His desire. Praise the living God. Hallelujah. His what? Desire. So God is in a position of doing whatever you ask him to do. But after that, he stands beside and watch at you. Go back to Matthew 16, 26. For what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world? My dear friends, my dear brethren, today churches can be empty. People have taken their things to be number one more than serving God. People have taken their activities and they are being busy more than serving God. And to young people like us, many of us say that I still have the long way to go. Listen. If you cannot make your way now, there is no day you will make your way. Praise the living God. Listen, any father of faith you see around, they are strong in faith till today because they started the race kitambo. It is only us that joke with God. It is only us that take serving God to be for granted. It is only many of us that does things that are so nasty in the presence of God, but at long last, we are still there, assuming that nothing happened. There's a living God. And loses his own soul. So to me, if you gain the whole world, you lose your own soul. Listen to me. The only thing we need is God. After getting God, you get everything. To me, if I have God, and the Bible says that with God, everything are possible. So to me, if I have God, not the world, I got everything, because everything I will declare shall come to pass. Is somebody getting my point? I'm rolling down. That is Luke number 1:32. The Bible said, for with God nothing will be impossible. So to me, if I have God, nothing can be impossible. Praise the living God. Listen to me. There is one thing that I believe in my life that have helped me to push forward. That the level where I was 3 years ago is not the level I am today. Because of what? For with God, you will climb steps and go higher. For with God, Mark 8:36, the Bible said, for what will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? 37. Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul? So to me, it is here. 2 in 1. The world and God. So if you give your soul to the world, you lose your soul. But if you give your soul to God, you gain your soul. And that's why I was saying, the Bible says that everything shall come and pass. But only the word of God shall remain. So listen to this. Everything you see in the world shall pass and go. Praise the living God. I usually tell people, even how handsome you are will pass and go. Vincent, even the best suits you love in your drawers shall pass and go. Praise the living God. Listen to me. Linda, how many hairstyles have you changed in your hair? Praise the living God. They come and pass. The Bible says, everything in heaven and in earth shall come and pass. But only the word of God shall do what? Remain. So, do you understand and know that the word of God is God? Do you know that? Do you know that the word of God is God? Let me prove for you. Give me John 1:1. That the word of God is God. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God. To me, there was the word, but the word also was with God. Like I'm beside this bucket, I was with the word. And the word was, praise the living God. Vanessa Sifiwe. The word was. So the word is God. So to me, if I have God who is the word, I have everything. To me, I will never pass and go because I have the word. Because that Bible says that it is only the word of God that shall remain forever. So what does do you need? You only need God. So if you have God, you have life. If you have God, anything you desire, that's what the Bible says, that seek the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and everything you desire shall follow you. But today, people are too busy. Busy. Mimi kama wezi nipea ni ubiri. Sisi enda hapo. Praise the living God. Mimi kama wezi ni recognize. So what is recognition? Kama wezi ni recognize. I have no business there. In fact, I have a lot of things to do. Praise the living God. Saints, for us to access and to conquer kingdoms, we need God. We don't don't need man. For if I have God, the Bible said that Jesus grew in stature. He grew in stature. In stature. Kwa kimwili, Jesus grew. And he also grew in wisdom. With favor. Praise the living God. With God and the man. To me, if I grew in stature and I grew in wisdom, having God, I will have favor automatically with men. So I don't need to kujifanya. Like nowadays, many of us wanajifanya. Wakiwa mbele ya pasi, umeroware my deputy Jesus, anaenda binguni piacha. Ameokoka yote. Yani, ameokoka. Na full stop. Ameokoka. There's a living God. Lakini wacha pige tu kona. Kona. Kona tu. Wamlambes. Wamlambes. Nyambe tamualu. There's a living God. Anapiga tu kona hivi. Listen. What does you gain when you live in sin? Praise the living God. What does you gain? Young people, we need to rise up. Listen, wachana na excuses. Eti nani pia si amefika pale na alikuwa anafanya vitu nafanya. Listen to me. You are not that person. And you don't know the reason why he's still alive. When I go to campuses and you hear from people, eti, how was Chana was see you? Hey, you are off. Listen to me. Ooh. I tell people, the moment you declare that you are saved, you have followers. Hata kama wakuambi like, uniombe, uniombe, they know you are saved. And they don't expect how you walk. Praise the living God. They don't expect how you walk. Because they expect a righteous man who have everything. Listen to me. Listen, I was identifying something. The reason why we are still walking and at times we lack is because we are into the world more than into God. Because the Bible said that we are a chosen generation, a peculiar people, royal priesthood. You know, being a royal. Huh? Have you ever listened? Have you ever had a royal family? You are watching Afro Cinema continue shortly. You understand these things. A royal family, Priska. Royal family. When you leo ni birthday yako. Let me tell you. They surprise people with cars. Have you ever watched YouTube and you find like somebody is just a birthday gift? Where would you have to say 200? Birthday gift, carry. Praise the living God. We mutu ajakata ajaku stiwa tena mtumba ya 20 mtumba. Praise the living God. Say amen. A royal, listen. A royal. Woo. You know, somebody who is royal, there is authority carries. Authority he carries. How many people saw when Kibaki was being buried and he was being transported from Nairobi to Obaya? Huh? Barabara, hata kuku haikuwa, kuku. Na ujaribu zuie barabara hivi. One day, President Uhuru Kenyatta came to Kisumu. I think there was a holiday. Na us, as people of Kondele, we love standing in Kondele. Flyover. Wanasa sifiwe. So men who thinks like they are men stood kwa barabara. Ili wazuie President asifanye nini? Asipite. When I don't know, there were only four men. Only four. My friend, barabara was clean immediately. Ju venye waliruka kutoka kwa gari, I don't understand. Na viboko na maslap. My friend, iwoke yono makatanete katayot. Being royal. Praise the living God. Amen. You know, it is only a king that can order any nation he leads and people follow. Huh? Curfew, as from Samoja, Kisumu County, Samoja isikupate inje. Ven, kuna siku ulipatikana inje, kapita chini ya uloko. Praise the living God. Hallelujah. You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people. To mean God has his own special people. That you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. To mean living in darkness is living in the world. Hallelujah. Is living in the world. Matthew 10, 27. Aha. Bible say, whatever I tell you in the dark, speak it in the light. What you hear in the ear, preach it on the housetops. Wow. 28. And do not fear those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Woo! Listen to me. It is only living in the world that will kill the soul. But if you live in the kingdom of God, ooh, I can never fear anyone because God is with me. If I have God, I will never fear because it is only the world that kills the soul. Ooh. Somebody, are you getting my point? Is somebody getting my point? Do not fear those who kills the body. Listen to me. Which doctor can only kill your body? Sorcerers can only kill your body. People of your neighbors that are so wicked can only kill your body, but they cannot kill your soul. And that's why somebody can die, but people can still see his soul. When you have God, those people can only kill your body, but not your soul. So to me, even if my body dies, but my soul lives to see the everlasting coming of Christ. Praise the living God. Do not fear. Why do you fear? Listen to me. You only fear because you live in darkness. You only fear because you spend your time in the world. You only fear because of what? You say, I cannot follow that route because I know a wicked man stays there. You say, I cannot follow that home because that man is a witch doctor. Somebody, let me proclaim to you tonight. If you carry God, those people can only kill your body. If you carry God, they will never, ever kill your soul. never on earth will they kill your soul. My God. That's what God is saying. God, fear not for them that kill the body, for they cannot. Listen, they cannot. Listen to me. If you have God, you can never ever fear. Listen to me. There was a time in the Bible that Elijah was being chased by Jezebel and King Ahab. But what happened? One day God spoke to her. The God spoke to Elijah and he told Elijah that, Elijah, I want you to go back to Israel and tell King Ahab that the rain that I've been missing for 3.5 years will rain. And do you know what happened? As Elijah rose up and he met King Ahab. After meeting King Ahab, he spoke to King Ahab and he told King Ahab, do you know what, the king? I want every prophet of Baal and the prophet of Asherah that let us meet on top of Mount Carmel so that we may know whose God is powerful. Praise the living God. When those people, when those prophets met, listen, you can be just a one man in the presence, in the midst of several wicked people. You can just be a one man that is walking in righteousness. You can make your family to bow to your God. You can make people from your surrounding to bow to your God. The Bible says that Elijah told them that we are going to give a sacrifice. Take one cow and I take one cow. Prayer until fire comes from heaven and burn the sacrifice. Listen, if you have God, never will you fear wicked people. At times, we have young people that say, you know, in our family, nobody have ever excelled. You know where I'm coming from, where my background is, people have graduated and there is nothing well. At times you look at yourself and you say, I've tried my level best and things are not working well for me. But at times if you look at the lineage of your family, you're finding that things that are happening in your surrounding are things that have ever happened in your family. Listen unto me. If you carry God, you carry the superpower, man. When you carry God, things that could have never happened, they will start happening because you are living with the man who can kill both the body and the soul. But rather fear him who is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. When you carry God, listen to me, your God in you can make wicked people to bow or die and miss their soul and body. Samuel 1, 1 Samuel 1, 12. 1 Samuel 12, 21 to 22. We are going to pray. Me, what I want is just God. Yeah. You know what? Just God. And watch at that person that I say, that I want just to live with God. What's their lives after 2 years or 1 year? How will they look? Listen to me. Saints, before I got born again, I lived a miserable life. I desired a lot of things. I struggled in life. I remember at times I could walk going to school and I get into town and find my dad and I ask him, Dad, it is now time to go to school. And dad could tell me that, my son, I've looked for money and I think you are not going to school. Go back home until tomorrow. Listen to me. When I joined Form 1, my dad left me with a pocket money of 30 shillings, 30 bob, and you are in a boarding school. If you know you are a Form 1, utakula mboga time ya lunch, but time ya supper utatapika. Praise the living God. Because it is a kind of a food you are not used to. Listen to me. After being born again, it has never been easy. I remember one day, I was translating to a certain man of God, and I have a certain khaki. And when we were in the midst of preaching, Ojambe, you know those people, Yesu nyalo, inawezekana. My trouser, ikachapa, because it was a wash and wear. Listen to me. What does it profit a man if he gains the whole world? Listen to me. One day, I went to a certain mission with some of my best shoes, loafers. And you know how loafers zinazeeka. So kwa bahati mbaya usiku, loafers zangu kijiti ikadunga mbele. Hadi kidole yangu, kidole cha mguu yangu ikatoka nje. And you know, praise the living God, tomorrow in the morning you are the preacher. Omera, tuba, preaching. But my mind is in my shoe. Yani nimeinua, itinge malo niye, mondo kikle thege penyi top power. Praise the living God. Listen to this. What does it profit a man? Dear saints, my fellow youths, your living with God will never go in vain. Your struggle serving God will never move in vain. For God is a faithful God. For he will come at the right time to open doors that were closed for your life. God. The Bible says, and do not turn aside. For then, you will go after empty things which cannot profit and deliver you. Saints, the Bible says that. Do not turn aside. For then you would go. And many of us are running for things that cannot help them. Yeah, things that cannot help them. I was searching my heart today in the morning and I was asking God, God, let me turn aside to anything that will never profit me, for they are empty. They will never deliver you. Some people say, I'm doing this because I want to deliver my home. There was a certain mama who released a daughter to go and prostitute with a sponsor. Hili akule hajab. Mstana anaenda anauza mwili yake anarudi. Anakuja na shopping. What does it profit you? Listen to me. Here is where we are in the age where young boys and ladies are confused. Everywhere they enter, wakuna new catch. And they don't understand themselves. Listen to me. What does it profit you? Listen, running for things that are empty. Whoo! They will never deliver your home. They will never sustain your future life. They will never transform who you are. They will never change the picture of your home. Listen to me. They will never. And you find people say that mimi nataka tu mtu wa haria. Yeah. Listen, we have had a lot. A lot. It doesn't profit.
for they are nothing. 22. For the Lord will not forsake his people. It is, listen to me. You only need God. It is only God that you need. Leave alone things of life. Let them be just a prayer item. Seek way to prayer items. But your focus should be God. Because the Bible says, for God will not forsake his people. Me, I want to be a person of God. Whenever I do my things, I am of God. Whenever I walk in the midst of my youth, my fellow mates, I am of God. I am of God. For his great name's sake. Listen. God fears to be ashamed. God fears to be ashamed. Listen to me. There is nothing bad if you are saying you are saved and calling the name of the Lord now machine. You know, we are gathering eagles that are so courageous. Courageous. God will never forsake you for his own namesake. So whenever you say you are saved, you have a rubber stamp that allocates you and says you are a son of God. And the moment you carry the rubber stamp, God will never forsake you. Because it has pleased the Lord to make you his people. Somebody, I'm talking to you tonight. It will never profit you. The only person you need is God. Is only God. Vincent, the only person we need is God. Let us make God our first priority. Let us not be people that Sundays are the days when we sleep much. Listen to me. We only need God in our worship. Listen, in your worship, in your singing, in your worship praises, you only need God. For because if you are singing and God is with you, deliverance occurs. Lives are transformed. But when you sing, because you have voice, one day you will miss the mark. You will mess up. Listen to me. If you have God, hata kama sauti yako ni mbaya, kama ya wengine, wacha nikwambie, Mungu atakutendea mema. Atafungua milango ambazo wanadamu hawezi fungua. Atafanya mambo, watu hawataelewa, Mungu atafanya. Me, I say to myself every day, even if my parents that were born again 40 years ago, I will never forsake salvation because wameacha. Because every person has a goal. Look at yourself. You are serving in youth jam. What is your goal? What is your goal? Listen to me. You must have a goal. Yeah. You are a present worshiper. Are you just, do you just want to sing here, day in, day out? My friend, that is not growth. Growth is, you do something, unatoka hapo, kila mahali umeingia, unatoka, kama umeenda kiwango kingine. Yeah. Listen to me. As we never started ministry na ku preach. Listen to me. We never, in fact, I was also a singer. Hadi nilikuwa naitwa missions ya kuimba tu. Praise the living God. There are places nikienda, wanajua bado mimi ni singer. was a living God.
Every level you are not supposed to be there. That's why that person sing and say, Mahali niliko, si yangu, naenda kiwango kingine. What is your desire in serving God? Faith, what is your desire? What is your desire? It will never profit you if you gain the whole world. Wow. The Bible says that fear not them that can only kill the body. If I have God, I have somebody who can kill both the body and the soul. And that's why tunasema mtu ameokoka hawezi rudi kuchieno watu. Mtu ameokoka. If you are truly saved, you cannot come back and change your heart. There's a living God. Never. Niambie mahali. John the Baptist alirudi. Eti amekachwa kichwa. Sasa kichwa ndo inatembea. Inaproga watu. Wapi? Tell me. Where? If you carry God, He will never forsake you. Linda, never will God forsake us. Somebody rise up from your feet. I don't know which kind of prayer item do you want to have, but you need God. In my service, I need God. In my worship, I need God. In everything I do, I need God. Somebody lift up your voice and say, Lord, here I am, that I need you. I need nothing else. For I found that the Bible says, that I shall profit nothing if I gain the whole world, but I shall profit everything if I gain the kingdom of God. In the name of Jesus, I declare and I decree that our lives shall never be forsaken. For the Bible says that God shall be there for us to deliver us, to provide to us, to give us the desire of our hearts. The Bible says that I shall give you the desire of your hearts if you will delight yourself in the Lord. Somebody lift up your voice. Somebody, you can lift up your voice and you can say, Lord, here I am, here I am, here I am, here I am, here I am. Deliver me, deliver me, deliver me, deliver me, deliver me from the love of the world, from the love of the world. That I now want to walk in your desire, that I want to serve in your desire, in the name that is above every other name. Zagada bagada, leta zada, zikete bayanda, lipa katoza, zikete bagaya, lapa kataya, zile baganda, lipa soda, zikete baya, rabagada gada, lato bagataya, zile baganda, ripa kataya, zile bayanda. Somebody lift up your voice. If you need God, you say, God, deliver me from the love of the world. Deliver me from the love of the world. Deliver me from the desire of my flesh that are not giving you glory. In the name of the Jesus, the Bible says, what is it that will profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Somebody tonight, here we are. God can do something new in your life, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. If I have God, I have my soul. If I have God, I have my soul. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the name that is above every other name, we declare and we decree that we shall stand to serve God in our dispensation, in our time, in the name of Jesus. Zagada bagada, zele bagadaya, lapakatoba, zele bagadaya, lipakatela, zele baganda, zala bagadaya, repekete, zegedegede, rabagadagada, repekedaya, Zalabagadaya, Rabagadela, Zegedegede, Lipagato, Zegedeba, Labagada, Rebegedegede, Rabagada. Somebody, atmosphere is being opened. Heaven is opening. Heaven is opening. Zaya, Zagaya, Lagada, Rebegede, Zelebagada, Labagada, Zegedegedega. Zelebagada, Lipagadaza, Zegedegedea, Lapagada, Zetebegedola, Zelebagadea, Lipagadela, Zebegedea, Zetapagada, Lipagada, Lipagadegedea, Ripagadela, Zegedegedegedea, Ra, Zelebaya, Lapagada, Rebegedea, Ripagada, Zebegedea, somebody prayer, somebody prayer. Somebody prayer on behalf of our mates. We declare, as we declare tonight, we are taking over. We are taking over, for we have the everlasting God in the name that is above every other name. Liar. We give you glory. We bless your name. Somebody lift up your hand. Somebody lift up your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, that tonight we have found that it doesn't profit anymore. If somebody loves the world. But I pray tonight that, Lord, we are making a decision that we will live with you. For the Bible said that with God all things are possible. Father, it is only you that we need. That if we have you, we will mount higher like eagles, that our strength will never be worn out. I pray, Lord, that through this, let us see a transformation in our desires, that we may just desire to have you in our lives. We give you glory and we bless you. We love you. And for in Jesus Christ we pray. Somebody put your hands together to God. Before you sit down, we are giving our offerings. You can hold your offerings so that I pray for it. If you have it kwa simu, you can put it to my number. We'll forward it to the treasury. Hold your offering. Let me pray for it. Father, in the name of Jesus, Ojambi, you can mount my number. We bless your name. We adore you. You're worthy. And you are great. Have your way, for you are a faithful God. Receive all the glory and all the honor. As we give, bless every hand. We bless you, and for in Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. Media, you can mount it at equal wall so that our online viewers, members can also support us by giving. God bless you. Somebody don't leave. Tunatoa sadaka, sadaka emigoloka. God bless our online viewers. God bless you so much. Amen.